There is always good pattern in capitalistic system. First will be the idea, good execution, good level of recognition, therefore the fan base. The next phase is when you get more popular, you get even more fan base and the quality is average. And the third phase, when you got your fan base and no matter how bad is quality at this stage, there is always be fan base that you can keep your hands on. At the first place, the man with idea, who keeps the system going, who keeps the process going, and he keep up. After, there is investors. Investors want money and therefore quality must be lowered because you can keep up. In the third stage, there is no more man with idea. There is only investors and the investors want money. Therefore, quality must go bad because in the process you must gain the highest level of profit that you can. But there is always one pattern in whole the capitalistic system. First, it's idea. It's good and everybody gets the good quality. Second, it's average, many people, everybody satisfied, but there is some that don't like it. And the third phase, when you have no more idea, all you interested in is only a profit. And the quality of everything is going shit, literally shit. And that is what the flaw of capitalism in essence. It starts up good, but the more you need profits, the more investors you have, more low quality products must be produced. Even more investors, even more loans, even more demand for the profit, the lower the quality. It's the problem of the capitalistic system in essence. And Ford and GM and Chrysler are showing it very well. If you want the big scale, Apple is the big scale product that going shitter and shitter, but the fan base. People will follow through no matter how shit is quality because people tend to follow the idea but not looking at some components of this idea. People will follow any idea. With our society, disengagement with capitalism more and more comes real because the level of production is going shit. The level of output from this production is going shit and shitter with each day. And it's not about the goods, it's about that system is broken. And more people understand this idea. That system is broken, therefore we must fix it. How can we fix it? We don't know. And of course there is huge bunch of people who still profited from the system, still think it's okay for them. Because more or less American society, for example, it's not about the society, it's about the person. Therefore, I'm good, therefore capitalism is working. And many people thinking this way. And other people just will follow through. It doesn't matter what shit will be going on around you, you will follow the idea because you once in love with it. It's the human nature. We must understand this. So the problem is not in governments or some individuals, while individuals is to blame, but they just simply working as the system goes. And people are egoistic in essence. Yes, we live as society. Yes, we live as a tribe. And it's easier to survive like this, but there is always ways for single person to prosper inside this group, inside this tribe, inside this society. And therefore, if people can get some advantages, they will get this. But if you look at this as a whole system that works like this, you will finally understand that the problem is not in some people, not in some persons. The problem is how the capitalism working as a whole system. Can we change it? Probably not. Can we get socialism right now? Probably not, but not with that level of assurance. But in the end, you will get the system that failing all the time. Failing because the flaws that lies inside of the system. And therefore, we must look at not some government or politics, but at the system as a whole. Socialism doesn't fail. It's always capitalism that's failing, more and more. While USSR, for example, was socialistic society, it was prosperous. But when USSR supposed to became a new capitalistic franchise, USSR failed. Therefore, it cannot be called as socialism fail. USSR wasn't a very much socialistic society. It was social society, but not socialistic. It was pretty much a state capitalism. When Gorbachev came to power and he wanted capitalism and democracy, USSR immediately failed. Therefore, I can't call it the fail of socialism because there was no real socialism. It was the fail of capitalism itself. Of course, you may call me an apologist for bloody regime or something like that. I don't mind. I don't really care. I'm not very sure that socialism is possible. I'm not very sure that communism isn't utopia. But I don't think that capitalism is the way to go for society as a whole. Maybe for some individuals and some persons, but not that for society as a whole, as the world society. Capitalism isn't the right way to go. There always must be the master and the slave in capitalism. Nothing changes. Nothing changes since Egypt pharaohs. And we must look for solutions. We must search for it anywhere else. Socialism, probably. Some parts of it. Capitalism, no. Not at all.